isn't there some benefit to having the government steal our money, which is what they do effectively? They hold a gun to our head and say, pay us 40% of your income or go to jail. They take this money and they give it mostly to government employees. Well, the government employees spend it. The marginal propensity to consume is pretty high. So the people who were robbed have to do something creative to get the money back. And isn't this creative activity the real wealth?
No, the third part of your thing is just pure fallacy from beginning to end. Let's suppose for a moment, take the extreme case, that 40% is being used just to have people sit around. The fact that they spend their money doesn't alter the situation. The only product there is what the 60% produce. And that 60% is divided among the 100%. If those 40% are also producing goods, then there are more goods to go around among everybody. You are just involved in a fallacy of looking at dollars instead of looking at the real product, the goods and services that people produce and people consume. Spending isn't good. What's good is producing. What we want to have is more goods and services. And as I say, the obvious indication that that's clear is that if your logic were right, it would apply it for 50%, 60%, 70%, 90%, 98%, 100%. And obviously, you would see that that would be a bunch of nonsense.